There's over 200 factors in Google's algorithm. So how do you ensure that your site is buttoned up when you don't have the time and even heck the energy to learn all the 200 factors? Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna teach you how to optimize your on-page SEO. Now, before we get started, make sure you like and subscribe to this channel. And if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. Now, the first thing that we're going to end up doing is heading over to Ubersuggest. And you can go to neilpatel.com/ubersuggest or just ubersuggest.com. And then I want you to type in your domain name and click search. You'll end up seeing a traffic analyzer report that looks something like this, where it breaks down your site, the traffic, your top pages, the top keywords that you rank for. And the reason I'm going over this really quickly is because it's not how you're gonna button up your traffic. There's actually another report in here. Now, if you don't have much traffic, you may see a blank screen that tells you, hey, let's fix your site errors. That's if your site is new and has barely any traffic. Instead, go to the sidebar, look at SEO Analyzer, click on Site Audit. In this report, it'll crawl your whole site. Now, my site's already crawled, recently crawled it. If your website, if you make the SEO changes, you can click a recrawl button if the crawl date is too old. But in most cases, your site's not gonna be crawled. It'll take a little bit and it'll crawl, you know, 100 pages, 1,000 pages, 10,000 pages, depending on your site. Now, let's break down how you optimize for these 200 factors. First off, it's a little bit too hard to learn all of them. So what you just wanna do is try to optimize and get your SEO score above 80. And the reason I'm not telling you to get 100 or 99 is because of this one important thing. If your SEO score is 100, that means you've optimized all of your pages. As you create new pages on your website, there's no way they're gonna be perfectly optimized out of the box. When you're creating content in quantity, when you're building links in quantity, when you're working on doing social shares, some things aren't fully buttoned up, and that's okay. And if your score is 100, that just means you're not producing enough content, creating enough new pages fast enough. But as you do those things, you'll notice that your score will drop, assuming you're already at 100, and you just wanna optimize to get above 80. So that's a sweet spot. Anything above 80 is pretty good. And then, of course, you'll see organic monthly traffic, keywords, how many backlinks you have, and how many pages crawled, things that are broken, issues, blocked, redirects, healthy. And I want you to first start off with the critical errors, right? We'll get to that in a bit. But then as you scroll down, site speed, desktop, 3 seconds, mobile, need to work on this. The page didn't load up, took a little bit too long. And it breaks down the issues with the areas that need to be fixed. The greens are good. The little pinks or reds, whatever you want to call it, are bad. So you would want to fix that. So as you can see here, my issues are more so the time to interactive and estimated input latencies. So I need to work on fixing these two for mobile and estimated input latency for desktop as well. And as I mentioned, if you hover over it, tells you what it is. So estimated input latency, this is an estimate of how long your app or website takes to respond to the user input in milliseconds during the busiest 5 second windows of the page load. If your latency is higher than 50 milliseconds, user may perceive the app or website as laggy. And then of course, as you scroll down, you'll see your top SEO issues. So I want you to scroll back up and let's first start with the critical errors. This again is your top issues that you need to fix. You may see some greens if things are good and there's no issues there, but I want you to look at the ones at the top. And it sorts them by difficulty, how easy is it to fix, and the impact. And if you're not sure what it is, like 26 pages with the low word count, you just look at what is this and how do I fix it. So what is this? Without enough text on a page, Google will have trouble understanding what the content is about. And then, of course, goes more in depth and then even says, how do I fix it? Add more content page so that it isn't considered thin content and has a better chance of ranking. In general, the average web page that ranks on page one of Google contains 2,200 words. Now, when you dive a little bit in, all you have to do is just click it, you'll see the pages that have low word count. Now, I want you to take this and really look at, hey, do I need to fix some of these pages? For example, this is my German page, and this is blog page 12. This is just pagination. Don't really need to fix that page. I don't necessarily need to fix this one, as this is an A/B testing calculator tool. I don't really need to fix this one, as this is my about page in Portuguese, which mainly just has a video. Some could even be my contact page. So you want to go through these and look for the pages that need to be fixed and the pages that don't need to be fixed. Some of the pages should be fixed and some of them don't. And the reason I say that is with this, and this is an issue with low word count, right? Some of your pages could be on, let's say, how to tie a tie. Do you really need 2,200 words on how to tie a tie, or even 500 words? Not really, just need some images, maybe even a video, and that's it. And that's for low word count. And I want to emphasize that one because for that one, not all of them are going to be fixable. And that can also bring down your score, and that's fine. But some of the other ones, like duplicate meta tags or title tags, you'll be able to see, all right, there's 4 pages with this error. There's 8 pages that just have the title of blog. There's 2 pages that just have the title of Neil Patel helping you succeed through online marketing, which is a bad title for this page specifically because it's in Italian, which means my team needs to translate it. And then, you know, you can go in there, you can look at issues like, you know, pages without H1 headings, and there's quite a few of them. I can go through these and start fixing them. And the list goes on and on. 6 pages return 400 errors, and there are 404. Which means I'm leaking to them internally from other pages, which is not good. So I need to fix that. 38 pages where the title's too short. Breaks them down, tells me what they are. I should probably make my titles like this one, blog, longer. You know, contact could be longer, like get in touch with us for digital marketing services, for example. And you'll just want to go through all the issues within this report. Ideally, your critical errors first, then the warnings, and then the recommendations. And when you do that and you start fixing all of them, then what you'll want to do is go back to Ubersuggest, more so the site audit. You just click the back button. And then what you'll want to do is verify that you fix these issues and then click recrawl, which then recrawls your website, goes through every single page, which can take time, especially if you have a big site. It doesn't just crawl your website in 1 second, and the reason being is if it crawled it too fast, it would be too many requests to your servers, which can impact the user experience for other users who are naturally visiting your website. So it takes a little bit to crawl your website, and we do that on purpose so that way we don't hit your servers 1,000 times per second and then slow down your experience for other users. So we're very picky and careful about that. But as it takes time, crawls your page, and then you'll get an updated SEO score. And you can see, hey, did these fixes help? Do I still need to go back and adjust them? What am I doing right? What am I doing wrong? And that's it. And if you do that, you can optimize your site and it'll start improving your numbers over time. And you can see if your score has improved, decreased, but this is how you optimize for the 200 plus factors that Google has, because we're inputting them in our systems as they release data, and Google gives us hints on what's affecting their algorithms and what people are running experiments on and what we're running experiments on to seeing what's working and what's not. And we're taking all that data and putting this in this tool so you yourself don't have to learn it. And you can just do this, run this report, and you'll be off into the races. Now, if you have any questions, leave a comment, let me know, and we'll do our best to help you out and get your technical issues solved. If you enjoyed this video, like it, share it, tell other people about it. And if you need help and you just want us to do everything for you, check out my ad agency, Neil Patel Digital. Thank you for your time.